Hello everyone. Today let us continue the chapter straight line. Here we will learn the different form of the straight line ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So this ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is a standard form of a line, straight line. Or we can say that general equation of a straight line if a and b are not zero simultaneously. If both are not zero simultaneously, then this ax plus by plus c equal to 0 will be standard equation or general equation of a straight line. Okay. Now we will learn here different form of the straight line. Okay. So let us see here which are the different forms. Slope intercept form, then intercept form, and the third one is normal form. Okay. So slope intercept form is, which means what? We will convert this ax plus by plus c equal to 0 in the form of y equal to mx plus c. Okay. So here ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So by will be equal to minus ax minus c. So if you divide this by b, so y equal to will get minus a upon b into x minus c upon b with, okay. So if you compare this with the y equal to mx plus c, so m will be, that will be slope of a line. So m will be this, means m will be slope of a line, m will be minus a upon b. And the y-intercept, c represents the y-intercept. So y-intercept will be minus c upon b. Okay, minus c upon b. So this will be what slope-intercept form. Okay, now where m will be minus c upon b and y means c value. Y intercept will be minus c upon b. When b equal to 0, if suppose b equal to 0, if b equal to 0, then you will get ax plus c equal to 0, which means x is equal to minus c upon a. In that situation, in that case, if x equal to something is given, which means it will be parallel to y axis, this value x intercept will be minus c upon a. In that case, the slope of this line x equal to minus c upon a, this line will be, slope of this line will be not defined. Why? Because it is perpendicular. So tan 90 will be not defined. That's why this you can write, this will be x intercept. Okay. Now let us see the intercept form. Now B part, intercept form. So intercept form of a line is x upon a plus y upon b equal to 0, equal to 1, sorry. Which means this ax plus by plus c equal to 0, you have to convert in this form. So you can write it ax plus by equal to minus c. Here we have to make positive 1. So we will divide whole equation by minus c, which means ax upon minus c plus by upon minus c equal to minus c upon minus c. So that will be 1, which means you will write this a upon minus c, you can write, we have to write x upon a, means that a we can write minus c upon a, means x upon minus c upon a plus y upon minus c upon b equal to 1. That will be slope intercept form, where x intercept will be this, y intercept will be this. Okay. Now next one is normal form. Normal form of a line is x cos omega plus y sin omega equal to p. X cos omega plus y sin omega equal to p. X cos omega plus y sin omega equal to p. and our equation is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So you can write this as ax plus by equal to minus c. Both the equations are similar. So you can write a upon cos omega. Ratio will be equal to b upon sin omega. This is also we can divide. Okay, so b upon sin omega and minus c upon p, which means you can compare if both the equations are similar, so you can their ratio will be equal. So a upon cos omega, b upon sin omega, and c minus c upon p we can write. So a upon cos omega you can write minus c upon p. So you can find the value of p. P will be what? Cos omega will be what? A p equal to minus c into cos omega, cross omega, cross multiplication we need. So cos omega will get cos omega is equal to what? AP upon minus c. AP upon minus c, that will be cos omega. Okay, similarly sin omega we will compare b upon sin omega equal to minus c upon p. So here also we'll cross multiply, so bp equal to minus c into sin omega, which means sin omega equal to bp upon minus c. Okay, now we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, so that identity we can apply here. Okay, sin square theta means sin square omega plus cos square omega equal to 1, this is the identity. So we can substitute value here. We will write here ap upon minus c whole square plus bp, means bp upon minus c whole square equal to 1, which means you can write a square p square upon c square, because minus minus it will become plus. Here also b square p square upon c square equal to 1. LCM will be equal because both are like fraction. So c square a square p square we can take common. So a square plus b square we will get from upside equal to 1. That p value we can find. P square equal to what? We will cross multiply. So c square upon we'll get a square plus b square. Okay, which means p will be plus minus c. P will be plus minus, that will be root of this. Okay, plus minus root of c square upon a square plus b square, which can be written as p equal to plus minus, that will be c square to c upon root of a square plus b square. Okay, now you can substitute here cos on p value, you can substitute this. So cc will be cancelled, so a upon root of a square plus b square will get, what will get the value? Sin of cos omega will equal to cos omega equal to cos omega equal to a upon minus c into p will be plus minus c. So we can write now plus minus here. Okay, c upon root of a square plus b square. Okay, so cc will be cancelled, so cos omega you can write it a upon plus minus a upon root of a square plus b square. Similarly sin omega also will get plus minus b upon root of a square plus b square. Okay, that will be sin omega and cos omega value. Okay, for the equation, which one? Normal form. What is the normal form? Sin omega cos omega x cos omega plus y sin omega equal to p. Okay, for this cos omega you can represent you can find the value a upon root of a square plus b square, and sin omega you can find by this, and p also you can find by this, and you put the value here, so you will get in this form. Okay, so let's see the question based on this.